I'm Megan O'Leary, and this is your UFC Minute. This weekend, we brace for a crucial matchup, which is expected to shake up an entire division. To get into position for a world title shot, this fighter has fought tooth and nail against the best the light heavyweight division has to offer. And while getting into a number one contender's match is sweet enough, if this fighter beats his heated rival to earn that shot at the belt, the victory would be even more satisfying. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
Coming up next, it's a UFC light heavyweight division encounter. All right, so here he is, folks. The wait is nearly over for this one. Unquestionably a rivalry fight. These guys have really stolen the show during fight week, jawing at each other at the weigh-in. No love lost between these two fighters. Only one man can have his hand raised here tonight. Let's see who can bottle the emotions and produce here on the world's biggest stage.
This guy has devastating choking technique. If he can get a hold of your neck, he can close it off like very few in the world.
So here's the unorthodox striker and former football standout at the University of Tennessee, the man they call OSP, Ovince St. Preux, blue belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. You remember the Von Flute choke against Nikita Krylov several years ago. No denying that he has pop in all limbs, but really an outstanding submission game. He's got a calf slicer to his credit as well. Ovince St. Preux, very much a finisher and a man who can beat you in a number of different ways.
This guy has some of the best throws we have ever seen inside the octagon. The speed of his execution and the technique that he uses in the delivery are truly world class.
Our tale of the tape for this light heavyweight tilt. So 2 years, the gap in age, some differences in height and reach. All right, now for the official introductions, the veteran voice of the octagon, Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC light heavyweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 15 wins, no losses. He stands 6 feet tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Prague, Czech Republic, the Warrior. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 33 wins, 13 losses. He stands 63 inches tall, weighing in at 205 pounds. Fighting out of Knoxville, Tennessee, Ovince St. Preux. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, our referee for this one.
Ready to fight? Ready.
All right, ready to go with live action here from Scotiabank Arena in Toronto, Ontario. All right, so here we go. Round one is underway of this rivalry fight here tonight. Perhaps there will be a little bit of a feeling out process here. Both guys were trying to put the emotions out of the equation here tonight. But it is rival versus rival under the lights here tonight. Oh!
Kick to the face!
He's got him right here.
Big left hand! And he establishes full mount.
Keeping busy here off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom.
Big Huge elbow to the head. He's posturing up here. He's moved to half guard here. His opponent pressed up against the cage.
Oh, nicely done there as he escapes back to his feet.
Check that kick. Oh, and he ate a front kick.
Well, he left his body wide open there for that hook shot, Joe, and he paid for it. He is leaning in. I know he's got the guard high.
Oh! He hurt him. He hurt him bad.
Oh, he might be out.
He's definitely rocked. Boom! Shin to the dome.
And he gets tagged. Nice combination, Joe.
Vicious combination.
He's got the clinch.
Oh, good opportunity to do damage here. He's got that tie clinch.
He hit him with the hook.
Kick lands.
Oh, the takedown attempt starting to pile up. Here's another one. Unable to secure.
Oh, he's got him down.
He lands the left there.
Good control, postures up. Nice shot to the head. Oh, he's
unbelievable.
Got the full mount, secured the position, and dropped bombs.
How about the ground and pound to finish the fight, Joe? That is as good an offensive execution as we have seen on the ground in recent memory. One big shot after the next. He wasn't just trying to score or buy time before the referee stood them up. He was trying to pound his opponent out of there, and that is exactly what he did. You wonder if some fighters will watch this footage and learn from that high-level offensive execution when it comes to the ground and pound.
And here we see that again.
And there he is after the huge knockout turned in tonight. Near-perfect execution and one of the bigger highlights of his UFC career.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 45 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, the Warrior.
All right, so the celebration is on in the corner, and he has certainly earned it after coming through and coming up large in this rivalry fight here tonight. He wanted this one in the worst way, and man, did he seize the spotlight here in this one.
Weapon formed against us shall not prosper. Young started with oozing noodles, now we eating lobster. As I walk through the valley with my ladder and flex, I'm the realest in it, I just happened to rap. When they all thought we was finished, they was laughing at that. So I went and bought me a dawn and flipped the head to the back. New drag, new whips on the way now. That your bitch on the way now. Mama told me if you fall, never stay down. Stand up, I can never lay down. Wins and them losses, you come with being bosses. Shoot up, in his head if he crosses. Transaction to trial, it's a fed making offers. 500,000, Louis said we looking awesome.